Hi, I'm Dr. Nemechek, and this is one of our new video blogs. I want to talk a little bit about Inflamaging. You'll find more details about this in the written portion of the blog post. So what we're finding in the general population, and this is looking to be like a global problem, is that as we age, there is a greater and greater concentration of these chemicals we call pro-inflammatory cytokines within the bloodstream. Now, this is a highly abnormal thing. These cytokines are generally released when you, say, have an infection or an injury, and they are a part of the normal, healthy inflammatory process. Say you get the flu, these things raise up, they help you recover from the infection. And then when you're done with the infection and you feel well again, these levels come down, all right? They go up temporarily and then they come down. What's happening is throughout the population, the older we get, we are able to detect these levels chronically in the bloodstream every day. They are not going away. And the older you get, the more inflammation you have. So you have inflammation with aging, and we now call this problem Inflamm-Ageing. All right, now why do we have to worry about this? Well, these cytokines do a couple main things. One is they'll damage tissue directly. So, you know, we think of like high blood pressure causing stroke and heart attacks, okay? Well, what we're really learning, it's inflammation is what damages the blood vessels. So inflammation will damage the endothelial cells that line the blood vessels. Inflammation is what damages the cholesterol that gets in there and causes trouble. If you have healthy cholesterol, it doesn't seem to be a problem. And inflammation also increases the likelihood you're going to form a little blood clot in that blood vessel. All right? So it will directly damage tissue. Now, this can also show up in some people as just tendonitis, bursitis, a nerve inflammation like a neuroma in the foot, fasciitis, plantar fasciitis on the bottom of your feet. So you go out walking for a day or you're touring or something, or maybe you're on your feet at work all the time, and the normal damage you get from just walking, the inflammatory process turns on, but it won't shut off, because you have all this other inflammatory chemicals being made. And now you wake up the next day and your feet still hurt from yesterday. And it's just day after day. That's plantar fasciitis. It's that you have inflammaging and you can't shut off the inflammation in your body. So one is, so it damages tissue. Two is this inflammation prevents your stem cells from functioning. And so a very good example, common example, is your cartilage in your joints. In the joint space in here are full of stem cells. And that's how through your life your joint stays healthy, is stem cells are constantly repairing all of this. Well, when you have inflammation, your stem cells don't work correctly, all right? And now your cartilage deteriorates, and this is called degenerative arthritis, all right? Or osteoarthritis. It just means the joint itself is falling apart. And this is probably the major reason why most people have a knee implant. Your knee surgery or a hip implant, the hip redone. This is your degenerative arthritis of your spine. It is really stem cell failure because of inflammaging. All right. Other stem cells that don't work right are up in the brain. So just that alone can trigger depression, chronic depression without any emotional trigger, okay, from inflammaging. Now, the third important thing it does is inflammaging is one of the main factors that will turn on the genes in your DNA and make you sick. So for instance, if you had a gene from your father for colon cancer, all right, what we believe now is probably the only way that gets turned on is with inflammaging. These cytokines, as these levels build up and up and up and up, they stress your cells, they will activate a thing called NF-kappa-B. NF-kappa-B kind of swims down to your DNA, and that gene for colon cancer that was sitting there nice and quiet, bingo, turns it on. Okay, we presently believe about 90% of all cancers are turned on by these inflammatory cytokines. Yes, if we didn't have this inflammation, about 90% of cancers probably would not happen. Okay, like skin cancer is not from the sun. Okay, the sun gives you a mutation for the potential of skin cancer if it is turned on, and you get those mutations by the time you're 30. You get them all over your sun exposed skin. But it's the inflammaging later in life that stresses the cells, NF-kappa B goes down to your DNA, bing, turns it on. All right? If you have a high-risk gene for something like breast cancer, it just takes much less inflammation to turn it on. Okay? That's why it's higher risk. But this applies for diabetes, cardiovascular disease, probably Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, all sorts of stuff. All right? But it's all from inflammaging. Now, where does inflammaging come from? It's a man-made problem. All right? Big sources are an imbalance of gut bacteria, something I talk about a lot throughout my blog. Another is excessive exposure to omega-6 fatty acids, linoleic acid. So this would be in soy oil, corn oil, vegetable oil, safflower oil, sunflower oil, all right? These are inflammatory. Now we need a little bit of these omega-6s, this linoleic acid, but we're getting about 20 times the amount we should. So on the other side of that, we aren't getting enough omega-3s, okay? Omega-3s, nuts, plant-based stuff, you need that, and then you need it from fish. They're different omega-3s. You can't get them from plants, all right? So we have this imbalance of 3 and 6s. Another source are some chemicals called advanced glycation end products, or AGEs, AGEs. And these are formed when we overheat food. So just stuff that's packaged food sold in the grocery store, if you heat a sugar and a protein molecule together, these will fuse together, and they form a very unnatural molecule called AGEs, highly inflammatory. And then a litany of other things. If you have an autoimmune disorder, they will constantly, like Hashimoto's, it constantly produces these inflammatory cytokines. So you add up all of this stuff, and it is contributing to the inflammaging. Oh, one other thing is when your autonomics break and your parasympathetic branch breaks of your autonomic nervous system, the parasympathetics completely control inflammation, and when that breaks, the break is off, and that's adding even more. So all of this stuff adds together and is the factor that allows this inflammation just to build and build and build as we get older. All right, you have to go and address a lot of these things. This is exactly what the Nemechek protocol is designed to do, and it seems to be very, very effective at shutting all of this off. So inflammation overaging is called inflammaging, all right? It's due to a man-made variety of inflammatory sources. You got to learn about this. You got to stay attuned to this. And if you do, it can greatly, greatly change your future. Have a great day. This is Dr. Nemechek.